Hello folks, Gilmer here, and this is my ongoing Let's Play of Birth America 2, Wars in America. We didn't really get that started into the game last time. We just opened up the scenario and took a look at the map and talked a little bit about the scenario. So if we press F1, F2, F3, F4, F5. So F5 gives us the victory points and objectives. 1779, Don Bernardo Galvez, Florida for the Spanish. This scenario covers the campaigns conducted by the Spanish governor of Louisiana between 1779 and 1781, which saw the conquest of British West Florida. And I think British West Florida included Mississippi and Alabama. I'm not positive about that. I do know that during the Revolutionary War, Florida was kind of not a battleground for America and the British, in the sense they weren't fighting over it. But I, you know, obviously I think the Spanish did have a presence there. Just about every game that I've played, it showed. And I don't know a lot of the history of this down here, so honestly, I'm not positive, but I do know that, you know, when I play Total War, the American Revolution, or whatever they call it, or Total War Empire, or whatever they call it, 1776, 1777, you play as the Americans or the British colonists fighting Great Britain, and then, of course, you're also, you have to take Florida at some point, and you have to take it from the Spanish and the Indians. So I've already read the scenario description, and then controlled objectives. It looks like we control Pensacola, Mobile, Natchez, St. Augustine, and Baton Rouge. That says Louisiana Territory. So as you can see, Mobile, which is now currently in the state of Alabama, was part of Florida. Pensacola is still part of Florida. St. Augustine is still part of Florida. So controlled 5. Total 5. Needed 5. Objectives condition fulfilled. Victory condition by VP accumulation. So I don't think there's a sudden death for this. With all objectives taken, the highest victory point count may modify the level of victory. This scenario will end in 1781. It's turn 1 and 28 turns remain. And then you have controlled strategic towns, Havana, St. Dominique, Kingston, which is the Cayman Islands, and of course Havana is Cuba. St. Louis, that's in Missouri. I didn't know we could go all the way to Missouri. It's in current day Missouri, but back then it was just the Northwest Territory. Natchez, that is in current day Mississippi, which is between Louisiana and Alabama for people who don't live over here. New Orleans is in the Louisiana Territory. Mobile, Pensacola, St. Augustine. So it's really kind of neat, some of the things that you can find. And here's a little bit of the historical background. I'll go ahead and read it for you. On June 21st, 1779, Spain declared war on England. On June 25th, 1779, a letter from London, marked secret and confidential, went to General John Campbell of Strathclair at Pensacola from King George III and Lord George Germain. General John Campbell was instructed that it was of great importance to organize an attack on New Orleans. If Campbell thought it was possible to reduce the Spanish fort at New Orleans, he was ordered to proceed immediately to make preparations. In an unfortunate twist of fate, the secret communication fell into the hands of Galvez, governor of Louisiana. After reading the communication from King George III and Germain, Galvez swiftly and secretly organized Louisiana and New Orleans for war. Galvez carried out a masterful military campaign and defeated the British colonial forces at Manchac, Baton Rouge, and Natchez in 1779. The Battle of Baton Rouge on September 21st, 1779, freed the lower Mississippi Valley of British forces and relieved the threat to the capital of Louisiana, New Orleans. In 1780, Galvez recaptured Mobile from the British at the Battle of Fort Charlotte. His most important military victory over the British forces occurred on May 9, 1781, when he attacked and took Pensacola by land and by sea, seizing this British and formerly Spanish capital of West Florida from General John Campbell of Stratcor. I keep kind of stumbling over that. That's not a name I'm familiar with. The loss of Mobile and Pensacola left the British with no bases in the Gulf of Mexico except for Jamaica, which is at Kingston. In 1782, Galvez captured the British naval base at New Providence in the Bahamas. He received many honors from Spain for his military victories against the British, including promotion to lieutenant general and field marshal, governor and captain general of Louisiana and Florida, now separated from Cuba. The command of the Spanish Expeditionary Army in America, and the titles of Viscount of Galveston and Count of Galvez. So I guess they named a fiefdom after him, and actually also a town after him, after he won all these victories. It's pretty interesting. Sometimes when you press these buttons, they don't do anything. So page 4, F4, gives us diplomatic options. There's nothing available at this point. Military options is F3, nothing available at this point. F2, available replacements, nothing available. And this does replacements a little bit differently than Civil War II and games like To End All Wars and probably even Wars of Succession and things like that. Rise of Prussia is a little bit more like this. And Rise of Prussia, I think, was developed after this, just after this. So the replacement being similar to Rise of Prussia makes sense. So if we go F2, F1, these are our forces. And most of these, I don't know what the red means, to be honest. I know this is our main army, John Campbell of Stratcor. But I don't know what the rest of these. This is a ship. This is army. Okay, so it's, I don't know that I can use those troops. They're locked right now. So let's find something closer. This is a ship. This is in Natchez. This is Natchez Militia. It's locked. Excuse my voice. For some reason it started cracking yesterday. I'm not cracking, but getting hoarse. Detachment. British West Indies. See, all of these are locked. Maybe that's it. Maybe if I go... No. I don't know. I know why. Because this is locked too. But I don't know why these are red and this is white. I don't know for a fact what that means. So I honestly want to say that I don't have anything that is actually, that I'm actually able to do at this point. My main army is sitting here in Pensacola, but it is locked in place. We do own everything but New Orleans. As you can see, can we go out? Can we? So it does come up here. So that's Lake Michigan. So that is Fort St. Joseph. Illinois Village, Peoria. There's St. Louis. St. Louis. And then we own Cahokia and Kaskaskia. Don't know how to really I'm not real familiar with these terms. But as you can see, we kind of have an outpost here and some outposts here in what I think is modern-day Illinois, Fort St. Joseph. I think Chicago is founded somewhere around in this area. And it might be on the site of Fort St. Joseph. I know that it's on Lake Michigan. So, then you have over here Detroit, Sandusky. This is Detroit, Michigan. Illinois Village. So, the state of Illinois is obviously named after the Illinois Native Americans. So, I don't think I have anything to do on this first turn, but if you remember when I read the description, the Spanish really went first. You know, they didn't, the British troops in America didn't know that they were supposed to fight or attack New Orleans because that communique or whatever they called it, the message was intercepted by the Spanish, and the Spanish attacked first. And I don't think that the British had enough time between when the message was captured or intercepted by the Spanish, between the time when they were finally informed, hey, you're supposed to be trying to attack New Orleans. So I think the Spanish went first in this situation. We have all of the overlays over here. As you can see, that the way they used to do games, they like to kind of do like this old world or old wood mahogany type look. And as you can see up here, it shows you the weather and the type of land. If you press the cursor over or hover the cursor over a region. So if we want to look at this Biloxi, it is swamp. As you can see up here, it'll say swamp over here. So if you look up there, it says swamp, and the weather on the right says fair, and it says over here fair. So if you look at that swamp, and it's fair. Swamp and fair. Clear and fair. So that's something to think about, because swamp area is very difficult to fight out of or inside. So that it's definitely something that we want to think about if we get anywhere close to these areas and decide we want to fight, because the quickest way from here to there, other than going by sea, which would be kind of quick, would be coming across here somehow. And I don't necessarily know I want to go through swampland, because it takes a long time to travel through swampland. And it doesn't really say how long it takes to some. In some of their games, it'll tell you how many days it'll take to get into or out of the region. But I don't think this one says it. Its civilization level is civilized and road. So there are roads through this area, but I honestly don't think in 1779 that the roads were probably in very good shape at all. They were probably more like, I mean, dirt roads and mud roads and, you know, tracks, basically, that in poor weather got real muddy and very difficult to pass through. So I'm not necessarily sure that I would want to go through these, even if it says fair weather. Just something to think about. And then, of course, all around Louisiana is swamp. Swamp, 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 swamp. And then you have forest right here. But the reason I'm pointing that out is if you want to attack New Orleans, especially in the game Civil War II, it's really difficult to attack New Orleans, because in Civil War II, there's a fortress over here, something that kind of commands us. So if you do an amphibious landing, you tend to want to do it here or here, I think, and not try to go straight at New Orleans. And I don't think it's very easy to get up the coastal waters with some of our ships. It might be possible, but amphibious attacks against cities in 1700s was probably not the most ideal way to try to take a city or any kind of land or conduct any kind of battle through an amphibious landing. So that's probably going to be a last resort. Although we do have this one ship, it says transport capacity 20. If you don't see that, it's the second line from the bottom. It says weight, no transport, and then transport capacity 20. That means it can carry 20, but it right now, currently, it has nothing. The weight of this army, if we can call it an army, as we've seen before, as you can see, if you can call that an army, 3,126 men and 243 horses. So, but it's still, if you hover over the tab, you can see, let's see, where is it? Okay, at the bottom it says, also here, VI detachment, 3 units, power 70. And then just above that it says, weight 33. So that is a weight 33, and that can only carry 20. So that army would not fit on this. We'd need 13 more transport capacity to load them onto a ship. Now, that's not to say we don't have ships somewhere, because I'm pretty sure we do. So we could potentially send some ships there, but I don't know where we would send them from. But I did see that we had some extra ships in other places. Let's see. Yeah, here we go. Here's some more ships. Mississippi Bateau. These are basically river-going ships, but I think they can go along the coastline as well. It doesn't really say, but it's locked, so I'm not going to be able to move it. So anyway, this will show the owner of all regions. The red is ours. The yellow is Spanish owned. So Spain owns, wow, this is, I don't think, quite right, because this is 1779, and that's Connecticut, or Burlington, controlled by Spain. And then this says, this is the Chesapeake Bay. And that's Arundel, Maryland. So that's a little weird, but I think I understand why. That's Lancaster, Pennsylvania, Reading, Pennsylvania, Philadelphia. So I think I understand why. And this is New York, why it says controlled by Spain. I think tentatively, Spain was an ally of the American Revolutionary Forces. So I think they're just kind of lumping them together in that sense. And so basically, it's on Spain. So the American colonists are on Spain's side, is what they're saying. And it makes sense, because they're both fighting the British, the Great Britain armies. Strategic cities. If you click on strategic cities, you will see they are shaded like this. So you have Natchez, Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Mobile, Pensacola, St. Augustine, Kingston, and the Cayman Islands. So those are important cities. St. Louis. Those are important cities to take. Now, I'm not sure I'm going to come all the way up here and try to take St. Louis. That's insanity. But I am going to try to take New Orleans. So let's click off that. This will show political states. I've never really understood political states, what it does, to be honest. If it's important, I don't think it's important. That's why I don't think I've ever really learned. I've never seen anybody worry that much about this in any playthrough I've ever seen. As you can see, it encompasses large swaths of land for each political state. Now, this is a supply level or lack of. That is very important because you need to know where your supply is and where it's coming from. Region allegiances. And so all of this is British allegiance. And then you have, through here, you have, well, you can't be entered in this scenario anyway, so it doesn't matter. And last but not least, grand regions. Again, not real sure about this. This is the globe to open up this. And somebody asked me if we can build supply units. And I don't think it is possible, actually. Because I'm not seeing anything. And I think what you have to do is you have to forage for your food. Because they're such small units. Let's see. It doesn't really say. So if you read the tooltip, it says my army currently has 146 points. It uses 40 per turn. And then the regions will tell you how much supply it produces. And these don't supply very much at all. So I'm wondering. You can build a supply depot. So what you have to do, if I'm understanding this correctly, and it's been a long time since I played Birth of America 2, Wars in America. What I think you have to do is a supply depot works about every three regions. So let's say if I had a supply depot in Pensacola, then I could go possibly to Chickahee, and build a supply depot there, and it would pull. That makes it very iffy, because then you have to worry about your supply lines being cut. Now, I will say that we have forts, actual forts, and I think you can build a fort too. Let's see. You must be in a structure, a depot, a fort, or maybe that says raise it, destroy a depot and destroy a fort. So I'm wondering. I mean, there is a supply unit right there. And so the way the supply units work is if you're in a town that generates, or a city that generates supply, and it's less than what your army uses, the difference will fill up a wagon if it's not full, but this one is full. So with an extra wagon of supply, we can survive longer out here. And so that might get us to a point where we can get down here. I don't know exactly how we're going to do it. But I will say in this game, you end up getting a lot of units per turn. So, I mean, not a lot of units, but you do get some units per turn a lot of times. You do in the main scenario, so I'm sure you probably get some here as well. And I'll probably get more troops too, and I believe that they will as well. What did I want? Oh, our current morale level is 95%. Why does that say 90? But the tooltip says 95. And it doesn't really say what my morale is down here. And it doesn't say what their morale is. Interesting. Anyway, I think I'm going to save this turn and let it play out. And then we're going to take a look. Okay, so you see they are moving to attack. And it's already... Well, I didn't get any information on that turn whatsoever. But they did do a move. And their total force of their army is... looks like it's not very big, actually. I think it's 25, 37. It could be as much as 94, 111. But I think its cohesion is probably pretty low, considering it marched from New Orleans through swamp up here. So let's see if the next turn so they've attacked Fort Bowie, my bad. We lost 118 men. They lost 65. They captured the fort. And this is the general, Galvez. His stats are 6, 4, and 4, which is pretty good. And then down here are all the attributes that came into play during the battle. And I've never really looked at these battle reports before in my playthroughs. I mean, I've looked at them before in just regular games where I'm playing that I'm not recording. But I've never kind of gone over those. So, if you go through these, you can see everything that affected the battle. And so, at least one army fleet had a defensive posture. Your luck rate on the combat dice rolls is 38. I'm not really sure what that means, other than 38 doesn't sound good if it's 38 out of 100. At the start of combat, there were one of your subunits that benefited from favorable ground. During the battle, your subunits failed one morale check. At the start of combat, there was one subunit of your side that were insufficiently commanded. At the start of combat, there was one subunit of your side on the battlefield. Your units opened fire at an initial range of 3. You have attempted one time to retreat. What does it say? Global combat value of the units initially committed, your side 12, the opponent 46. Total number of hits suffered, your side 6, the opponent 3. Opponent's units open fired at an initial range of 3. At the start of combat, there were 4 subunits of the opposing side on the battlefield. During the battle, your opponent's subunits failed 15 morale checks. At the start of combat, there were 0 subunits of your opponent that benefited from favorable ground. Your opponent's luck rate on the combat dice roll is 47, which is better than mine of 38. At least 1 army fleet of your opponent had an assault posture. And 10% defensive fire bonus and 1 extra protection for the stack if already entrenched. And then you can see, we already went over how many men lost. They had 711 men beginning. We had 118 and we lost 118. And that's it. We didn't have a commanding general. And that's the end of that battle. And this was a battle by a force that wasn't... their forces don't even have a commanding general. Now, we should get something in our messages this time. So, to answer the person, I can't remember your name at this point. But to answer the question about where we get supply units, I don't think I can build them in this scenario. I think it might be possible to build them in the full campaign or the larger campaigns, but I don't think I get a chance to build them in this scenario. I think he's still locked. That's Fort Butte. Garrison engaged Spain. We lost a battle. We have lost a battle in Dartmouth. Fort Butte Garrison is now active. Dartmouth Garrison, West Florida is now active in region Maurepas. Is that this? Yes. And then Spain captured Manchac in region Tonicus. Spain captured the harbor. And Spain captured the fort. That's here. And that looks new. I don't remember that being like that, but it's turn 3 and 26 turns remain. I hope I'm not locked until somebody actually attacks me. I'm already not necessarily beginning to like this scenario. I want to do something. And it probably would have been better to actually have been Spain, because they actually get to do stuff. But I am going to call the episode here. Thank you very much for watching. I hope it has been informative. I could have gone through a lot more of my units. We do have the Fort Garrison here in Pensacola. And then you get the little mini map over here that you can use to navigate around. You know, say you have something out here you want to take a look at, you can go out there. Or the tip of Florida, nothing going on there. And it also shows you where military forces are. So there's something up here that's that, and you can see the little red dot. And you can see some forces in St. Louis. That's one of theirs. Then we have some forces in this region and this region, as you can see. And then we have a whole line of forts going up the Mississippi. And then our main forces, our big forces, actually here. And then we have something there. And then we also have something down here in Jamaica. There's another supply unit. Hopefully it'll unlock at some point and we can drop it on. See, that transport capacity is represented in a different way. Interesting. Oh, it's because I'm hovering. I was hovering over the tab instead of the actual unit. Okay. All right. Well, thank you very much for watching. We will see you next time. Hopefully, we'll get a little bit more action in the next episode. Bye for now.